writing responsive design means dealing with a lot of media queries. You either design mobile first, where you give importance to a mobile screen and then build up for larger device sizes, or you write to desktop first and then build your site for smaller screen sizes. In either way, you have to deal with some media queries, where you check the minimum width of your screen and then set the properties of the elements accordingly. And it gets a little bit complicated after some time. And in this video, I'll show you the grid layout of CSS, using which you can build a basic responsive design without using any media queries at all. So I don't have anything fancy here. I just have one div, which is the container, and 12 divs with the class card. Basically, these will be my items, and this container will become the grid. So right now it looks kind of bad. I mean, you can't even tell where one item begins and where one item stops. So let's give these items a little bit of styling. Nothing too fancy. I'll just add some height, I'll add some padding, and a little bit of background color. So let's go with red. This is how it looks right now. So it takes up all of my screen, and there is still no space between these two items. And also, this does not look like a grid. Now these properties will be set on the container. I'll give it a maximum width of 1200 pixels. I'll also center align it using margin 0 auto. Still the items are arranged one after another, I mean in one column. I'll use the display property and set it to grid. Now at this point, it still looks the same, although the container has now become a grid. By default, grids are only one column. So that's why these items are all in one after another in rows. In order to have more columns, we have to set the grid template columns property. So I will set it to this thing. And we are done. See, don't believe me. So let's see what happens if I decrease the window. See, fully responsive without writing a single bit of media query. So how does this work? So the grid template columns property is used to tell the browser how much each column should be. How much wide each column should be. For example, if I put it to like this, let me comment it out for now. See, if I write this, it tells the browser that the grid should have two columns, each column is of 20 pixel width, something like this. Now of course it has a fixed width, so that's where we have one more unit known as the fractional unit. So for example, if I write this, this tells the browser that the grid should have two columns and the space should be equally distributed with the two columns, something like this. So no matter how wide or how narrow this grid gets, it will always have two columns. And each column will be of same width. If I, for example, set this 2FR, 1FR, it means that the grid will be three columns wide and the first column will be twice as big as the second column. Something like this. For example, if I want to have a grid with four columns with equal width, I would write something like this. Now this becomes a little tedious to write if you have a lot of columns. So we can use a repeat function from CSS. This does the same thing as before. It tells that I repeat the 1FR 4 times. The result is this: 4 columns with equal width. Now here's where the magic happens. Repeat has a special value known as autofit. For example, if I write this autofit and 200 pixels, So it means each column will be of 200 pixel wide, but the number of column is not fixed. So the number of columns will be as many columns as it fits in the viewport. For example, at this point I can have 6 columns, because of course the max width is set for the container. But as the screen size gets smaller, I may not have space for all 6 columns. So if I do not have space for 6 columns, they will go to next row. For example, like this. So at this point I have space for only 5 columns. So there are 5 columns in each row, and the extra elements are placed in another row. Something like this. So the purpose of auto fit is to tell the browser that fit as many columns as you can. Now this is the trick that I used here in my previous line. Here for the second argument I used another function known as minmax. So it basically tells the browser that this value should be a minimum of 200 pixel and the maximum of one fractional unit. In other words, I do not want my columns to get smaller than 200 pixels of width. Also, I do not want the columns to get bigger than one fractional unit. The result is a responsive design, as you saw. So you see, there is no extra white space like there was before, because each column were 200 pixels wide before. That caused a little bit of white space there. But right now, the columns will fill up the extra white space. And the result is this beautiful responsive design, and we have not written a single line of media query.